It seems like people are staying single longer than ever. Not only are people avoiding something like marriage longer than ever, but many are completely avoiding long-term relationships altogether. And it's easy to see why. Dating has never been more complicated than it is now. It's more difficult than ever just to meet someone. And when you do, relationships are hard work. So a lot of times, it seems like it's just not worth it. But on top of all that, it is legitimately great to be single. While we generally pity people who are single, and maybe we even pity ourselves when we are single, there is a genuine romance to being on your own. Søren Kierkegaard is, in many ways, the single person's philosopher. He was single his entire life, and much of his philosophy was shaped by his singleness. Nowhere is this more evident than in his book, Either Or, where he explored the ups and downs of being alone. According to Kierkegaard, singleness was like an infinite sea. It's adventurous and intoxicating. He writes, "You yourself can become youthfully intoxicated, almost beyond control, by the thought of this infinity that is your element. One seizes the moment, unfurls one's sail, sweeps along with the infinite speed of restless thoughts. Alone on the infinite ocean, alone under the infinite heaven, this is just the way you navigate the ocean of life." We love the experience of infinity, of vast spaces and endless possibilities. And as a single person, you live in that experience of infinite potential every day of your life. You feel like anything is possible. You can do whatever you want. You feel like you can become anything. You don't have to compromise. You don't revolve around another person. You're not tied down. You don't have to rely on anyone. And you don't answer to anyone. Alone in his kayak, a person is sufficient unto himself, has nothing to do with any person except when he himself so wishes. So it's easy to see why singleness is so appealing to us. The freedom and independence are addictive. They're hard to give up. Being single has a ton of benefits. But at the same time, there is a downside to being single. Anyone who has been single for any amount of time knows that being single means being alone, being isolated. It means going back to an empty apartment. It means eating your meals by yourself. It means doing things by yourself, or not doing anything at all, never going out. It means being bored. It means being lonely, not having anyone to talk to. It means there's not always someone there for you when you need them. And this can lead to feelings of isolation and being cut off, which can in turn lead to worse. You might feel like you're not important to anyone, like your life isn't meaningful at all. After all, what's the point of life if no one cares about your life except you? What's the point if no one cares whether you are happy or sad or suffering or achieving your goals or failing in your career? Maybe you are fortunate enough to have a really close friend or two, or a community or a work environment around you that helps you feel at home somewhere. But for many people today, that's just not the case. In our fragmented society, it can be difficult to find a place where you feel like you belong. And even if you do, it's nowhere near the same as always having someone with you at home. Someone who is always there for you. Everyone is different. Some people can handle being single better than others. But I think we are lying to ourselves if we pretend like being single isn't painful. Kierkegaard writes, "Allow me to point out the dark side of your life. Think of the pain, sadness, and humiliation involved in being, in a sense, a stranger and alien in the world. When you don't have any intimate relationships, you begin to feel like you don't belong in the world. And I think this reflects how a lot of us feel. We feel like strangers in the world. We feel like we don't belong anywhere. We don't have a place where we fit in. We feel existentially homeless. And that's not a good feeling. It's deeply painful. But as strange as it may sound, if we're honest, some of us also kind of like it. We kind of enjoy the pain of being a stranger in the world. It's poetic, maybe even heroic. It's the ideal of being the lone wolf, the tragic hero. Alone in one's boat. Alone with one's sorrow, alone with one's despair, which one is cowardly enough to prefer to keep, rather than to submit to the pain of healing." For Kierkegaard, there are two choices in life. Keep the pain, sadness, and despair of being alone, or submit to the pain of healing, which for Kierkegaard means getting married, starting a family, and taking responsibility for people other than yourself. Both options are painful, but keep in mind that the two pains are not the same. Singleness is painful because it's not how we're meant to live. Commitment, on the other hand, is painful because it's hard work. One is the pain of disease. The other is the pain of growth and improvement. In the end, Kierkegaard leaves it up to us to decide which life we will choose. Do you want the thrill of singleness and freedom along with the loneliness and isolation? Or will you commit your life to another person and take responsibility for a family and find a place where you belong, even if you have to make sacrifices for it? The choice is ours. If you're curious about how commitment can help you feel at home in the world, then check out this video on why life is better with family.